The ASUS ROG Swift PG27A is certainly an impressive monitor. 4K, IPS, G-Sync. It's hard not to be impressed by something this beautiful. Big thanks to ASUS South Africa for sending this over for review, and now let's take a closer look. The panel on this 27-inch 4K monitor is pretty stunning. Coming in at 163 pixels per inch at its max resolution of 3840 by 2160, simply everything on this monitor is incredibly clear and sharp to look at. Text is easy to read and graphics are sharp in their detail. And with the IPS panel, there's 178 degrees of viewing angles that make the images on the screen look the same no matter where you're positioned in front of the monitor. The monitor is sufficiently bright in well-lit rooms, and with 100% sRGB color saturation, images look how they're supposed to. However, there is some noticeable backlight bleed whenever the monitor isn't displaying an image, a common issue with IPS panels. However, while noticeable, it certainly isn't egregious. Covering the panel, there is a nice, non-glossy surface. The bezels on the monitor are also rather thin, with the top and sides coming in at less than 1 centimeter, and the bottom bezel, to incorporate the ASUS branding, is 1.5 centimeters. On the right side of the monitor, you have the menu buttons, which are on the rear of the monitor. To navigate the menu, there's a simple-to-use joystick, as well as various buttons to select certain menus. To access the general settings menu, you press the joystick in, and then you're able to adjust things such as the included blue light filter, which helps filter out the blue light that is supposedly what hinders our brains in going to sleep after we're on the computer. It's not something that I would use personally since I have no issues with the blue light on my screens, but it's a good idea for ASUS to include this feature. Then you have the typical brightness, contrast, and color temperature settings. Following that is the ability to adjust the image overdrive settings, also known as ASUS trace-free technology. Personally, I had a hard time with this setting enabled because it would cause YouTube videos where a person is the main image to look incredibly jittery. So I personally left that off most of the time. After the image overdrive comes the ability to select between the HDMI or DisplayPort inputs, and finally the system setup submenu, which allows you to change the language, the position, transparency, and timeout functions of the on-screen display, as well as other basic features, and then the ASUS Light and Motion setting. Light and Motion is the term used for the glowing lights that are on the base of the monitor. You have the option to have them on, which means there's red light breathing effect on the circular part of the stand, as well as the ROG logo, or you have the option to turn them off completely. Personally, I would have preferred some more options like variation of colors or just different breathing effects, but even without that, the red lighting accents are a nice touch to the monitor. Attached to the base of the monitor is the stand that the PG27A is mounted to. The stand comes with 120 degrees of swivel from side to side, 25 degrees of tilt, 20 up and 5 down, 90 degrees of pivot to set the monitor in portrait mode, and 120 millimeters of height adjust. The stand also doubles as a cable management hub with a section being carved out to route cables through. Or you could remove your stand altogether and attach a 100 millimeter by 100 millimeter VESA mount. Continuing on with the menu, there is also the ASUS Game Plus menu, which allows you to place a crosshair on your screen for playing FPS games. It also allows you to set a game timer and then also has a built-in FPS counter, which I thought was super nifty. Thanks for including that, ASUS. However, my gripe with this comes in the fact that you can't have more than one of these options running at the same time. You have to choose between the crosshairs, timer, or FPS counter. I'm not sure how much engineering it would take to include more than one at the same time, but I would appreciate that for future iterations. And the last menu selection is preset visual modes, allowing you to choose between 6 different modes such as scenery, racing, cinema, sRGB, and various others. On the back of the monitor, you'll find a power input, a headphone jack, DisplayPort, and HDMI input, as well as a 2-port USB 3.0 hub. All around, it's a solid monitor in terms of extra features and menu selections. But while those extra features are nice, they're not the main reason to get this monitor. The reason you should get this monitor is because G-Sync at 4K with a 4-millisecond response time is amazing. Since this is my first experience delving into a G-Sync monitor, I wasn't entirely prepared for the buttery smoothness that comes from the adaptive frame rate technology of G-Sync. And playing games at 4K was an absolute thrill as well. The high level of detail and scale of everything is simply an experience to be had. The PG27A is capable of 4K gameplay at up to 60 Hz, but good luck trying to get your GPU to hit those frame rates on AAA titles. It should be noted that the only way you're going to be able to make use of 4K G-Sync is if you have a card that can handle 4K gameplay. Thankfully, ASUS South Africa also sent over an ASUS Strix GTX 980 Ti for review, which you can check out here. So the 4K gameplay was no problem, with most games getting 40 to 55 FPS averages. However, if you're rocking a 980 or less, a 1440p monitor with G-Sync may be a better option for you. The only issue that I ever experienced when using this monitor had to do with Windows display scaling issues, where I would let the monitor go to sleep, and upon resuming activity, the monitor would briefly load into 1080p in the top left portion of the screen, and then finally revert back to 4K, but would keep the things such as the taskbar scaled to the 1080p resolution. And that leads me into my conclusion. This monitor is amazing. The screen is fantastic, and the anti-glare on the panel is useful in direct lighting conditions. The adjustability and the look of the entire thing are simple, but premium, since ASUS never uses glossy plastic, but instead opts for a matte plastic finish instead. Gaming with this monitor is truly an experience to behold. And productivity work, such as editing videos, is incredible as well with all of the screen real estate that you get. And I could 100% recommend this monitor for anyone who is actually going to take advantage of its 4K G-Sync functionality. But considering the type of system that is required to drive games at that resolution and the price of the monitor itself, ASUS is certainly aiming for the top of the gaming pedigree here. Coming in at $900 US, this certainly isn't an insignificant purchase to make. And in South Africa, most retailers aren't even carrying this monitor, and the one that I found that had it listed has it at nearly 24,000 Rand, making it more than what I paid for my entire Skylake system. That isn't to say that the PG27A isn't worth its price tag. Far from it, actually, it absolutely is. But rather, it's to say that it's a cost that needs to be counted as to whether or not you're actually going to utilize all of the functionality that it provides you. Because if you're rocking a GTX 970, gaming at 4K isn't a reality and you might want to go with 1440p. But if you have a beefy system, totally hit this thing up. And with that, I again want to thank ASUS South Africa for sending this monitor over, as well as the GTX 980 Ti for review. I'm glad I got to work with these awesome pieces of hardware. It was certainly an experience getting to game at 4K on this thing. So, like this video if you found it helpful, dislike it if you thought it was poo. You can subscribe to stay up to date on all of my tech-related content, and maybe even check out a recent build I did where we liquid-cooled an Xbox One and a Skylake PC and put it all inside of a MasterCase Pro 5. It's actually sitting right here. It's a pretty neat build project, so check that video out if you want to, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.